limited knowledge, therefore asking a basic question. If out of 6,000 verses, 1,000 are about scientific facts, then what really is the essence of the Qur'an?
This is a very good question. That if the Qur'an contains more than 6,000 verses, and more than 1,000 speak about science, what is the essence of the Qur'an? Sister, as I mentioned in my earlier answer, the basic essence of the Qur'an is Tawheed. Believing in one God and worshipping Him alone and no one else. And the Qur'an, as I mentioned, is not a book of science, S-C-I-E-N-C-E. It's a book of signs, S-I-G-N-S. It's a book of ayats. The Qur'an is a book which shows you how a life should be led. And when I had a debate with Shri Ravi Shankar, I said, this is the best book on art of living. If there is any book on art of living which is the best, it is the Qur'an. Best book on art of living. And it has a membership of more than 1.3 billion people. So this book shows you how to lead a life. Now many a time you understand that because the Qur'an is the word of Almighty God, one verse of the Qur'an has got multiple angles. Now the same 1,000 verses which are speaking about science, it doesn't mean it only speaks about science. It speaks aspects also. That's the beauty of the Qur'an. When a layman sees it, he understands it. When a scientific man sees it, he sees it in a different angle. It satisfies both. So that's the beauty of the Qur'an. That does not mean the Qur'an is a book of science. Yes, but there is not a single verse of the Qur'an which goes against established science. Because it's a book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty God. So this book is a book of guidance, how a life should be led. It shows a person to believe in oneness of God, how to worship Him, and how to lead the life. The pros and cons, the farais, what a human being should do, and the prohibited things that he should abstain from. It's mentioned in the Qur'an. Hope that answers the question, sister.
Sister, if you have another question, go ahead, if it's from a non-Muslim.
Your presentation is impressive, but could you just ask this group to raise their hands, who knew some of the information that you mentioned now? The thought here is, why is general education and the learning of the Holy Qur'an not integrated?
Sister has a question, but from the audience, how many of you knew the major portion of what I've said in the lecture? Please raise your hand. Major portion of what I've mentioned, mashallah, you can say most of them. At least more than 50%, if not all. And the reason is that I've written a book also, Quran and Modern Science, Compatible and Incompatible, which has been distributed in the conference. If those who have not got a copy, inshallah, on your way out, the copy of my talk, Quran and Modern Science, will be distributed, inshallah. It's a four-color book. Regarding the part of the question, the second part, that why isn't education being given to the Muslims? So I expected the sister would have thought that maybe 1% or 10%, less than 10% raised the hand. So here you see, mashallah, majority knew it. And yet they came for the talk, alhamdulillah. Maybe they came for the question answer session. That is the best part of the program. Sister, as far as Islam is concerned, the first guidance given by Almighty God in the glorious Quran, in the last and final revelation of the human beings, it was not to offer salah. It was not to perform hajj or pilgrimage. It was ikra, read, recite, proclaim. So the first guidance given by Almighty God in the last and final revelation, it was to read, it was education. And that's the reason the major stress that the Muslim should put is on education. And alhamdulillah, the people of the south, I know from Kerala and even of Madras, mashallah, of Chennai, as far as the percentage is concerned in the other parts of India, alhamdulillah, the Muslims in Kerala are 100% educated. Not Muslims, all Keralites, whether Muslim or non-Muslim, they're educated. So even culture counts into it. As far as the religion of Islam is concerned, every Muslim, he should be educated. So that's the message for those who are not educated, that acquiring education is important. And that is the first guidance given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the last and final revelation, the glorious Quran. Hope that answers the question.